Even the bark of ash trees has been used for various jobs. If you take a piece and fold that round, like so, then fold the bark in the middle, so you bring the other end over and wrap that around here. That can be lashed there and made watertight with the pine pitch and bear fat. You end up with a water bottle. You can carry liquids with you. Very neat. Another way to use the bark is to score an oval-shaped groove, something like that. And now, when I fold the bark, I push in here and fold, so that buckles inwards and makes a kind of a flat bottom. We have a neat basket which can be used for picking berries or anything like that. And we just sew up the edges using the spruce root. To complete the basket, I need to put a rim around the opening at the top to give it more strength. For that, I'm using the cedar here. And I'm heating this strip in the water so that I can encourage it to start to bend to the shape I want. You can see it's becoming nice and flexible. This part of the process is getting to know the material, getting to feel what the fibres do. It's terribly important. When you see these things done by people who are used to using materials, the materials in hand, it all looks very easy. And then you try yourself and you find things aren't as simple as they seem. And really the secret is actually getting to know the material, getting to feel what happens, gaining an intimacy with it, if you like. Where the ends of this hoop overlap, I'm thinning them so that they maintain an even thickness, tapering them down here with a crook knife. Just lash that in place with these two pegs, and now I can bind the edge with spruce root. Well, that's it. Putting the hoop on the top makes a huge difference to the strength of the container. Now that's only a small basket. You can make much larger baskets with obviously larger pieces of bark. But baskets of this size and sort were used by other peoples in North America, Canada, for collecting berries and tasks like that. Very durable.